Hello everyone, today I want to talk about the importance of shape in motion graphics. You may be wondering why shape, when we can do all the designs in Illustrator or Photoshop, why do it in After Effects using the shape tool? You should know that the After Effects shape tool, in addition to the capabilities and features that the shape tool has in Illustrator and Photoshop, has many other features that you can only find in After Effects, which can help you in both designing and creating beautiful animations and motion graphics. Let's see some examples of the powers of this tool in After Effects to fully understand why we need to do the motion graphic designs in After Effects. Suppose we want to make such a shape. If we make it manually, after the shape is made, to be able to sharpen these rounded corners, we must fix all of them one by one. But when we use the round corner modifier to round these corners, we just need to go to the shape and set the round corner to zero. You can see how easily we were able to sharpen the corners of the gear. Or for example, we don't want such a state. We want the gear to change to this state. See, as soon as I change it, the shape automatically changes completely. Or for example, if you want to increase or decrease the number of these gear teeth, you'll just need to use the repeater modifier. You can see how easily we are able to increase or decrease the number of the gear teeth or do anything else we want. And we won't need to make changes to each one of these gear teeth separately. Another feature the shape provides us is that we can create such strokes around the shapes. In perfectly symmetrical shapes, such as circles or squares, it won't be that difficult. We can also create it manually. But in such shapes which are not fully symmetrical, you can hardly do it. I'll show you. First, we need to make a duplicate of this stroke. Select its path and then resize it. When I change the scale, even though these parts are correct, these parts are not very accurate, and you must spend hours to be able to manually create the stroke I showed you. Therefore, we can easily use the offset path modifier and create such a stroke very simply. You can also adjust the distance between the stroke and your shape. Another good feature and ability of the shape tool is that you can easily create such a backgrounds very simply and easily. I'll show you. As you see, this is the background I have created. This is the monitor layer which I have repeated it using the repeater modifier, as well as the flower pots and the drawers layer. As you can see, I have created three drawers using the repeater. And as for this drawer itself, I had only created the upper part of it. I created such a drawer and then repeated it. Now, if you want to make changes to these files, you just need to go to this shape that you primarily made and easily change the color, and the color of all the other parts will change. So you won't need to select these drawers one by one and change their color. You can also change the form of your shape and apply it completely to the other drawers as well. And finally, create such a scene. Another good feature is that we can combine several modifiers and create such beautiful shapes. For example, to create this shape, I have used the repeater modifier, angle transform, merge path, and round corner. By disabling them, you can see what effect each one of these modifiers has on these shapes, and you will learn in detail how to create them during the course. Another ability is to create such animations. As you can see, I have animated the lines using the trim pass modifier. You can do such a thing only by the trim pass modifier in After Effects. Or for example, you can create such a mood for growing plants using this modifier in your work. In this example, as you can see, we have created two lollipops. I have made this spiral shape inside the lollipop using the twist modifier. It was just a straight line and I did the work using the twist. If you want to do such a thing manually, it takes you a long time to create such a shape with the pen tool, which in the end it may not be as accurate and beautiful. As well as this lollipop which has been created by twist and repeater. First, I created this piece and then repeated it using the repeater and twisted it using the twist. The next feature that shapes give us is that you can create wiggle animations for all the elements inside your shape layer. Well, if you want to create such animation manually, you must write the wiggle expression for each one of these shapes and set each one of them separately. But through the wiggle transform modifier and using a controller, you can easily control the wiggle of these elements and you won't need to create the wiggle animation for each of the elements. As you see, the wiggle transform modifier has greatly simplified the work in this scene and has saved a lot of the time. The next feature the shapes in After Effects give us is the ability to create such a vibrational state for the shapes. As you see, we have made such animation using wiggle path without needing to create these vibrational shapes one by one. In this example, we have created such a ripple using the zigzag modifier that making it manually not only takes a long time, but also takes a lot of energy from us. I think so far it's quite clear to you why we have to use the shape tools in After Effects to design the motion graphics. It is true that Illustrator and Photoshop are for design and are great for single frame design. But you should know that After Effects is also for designing motion graphics and it has its own tools for designing and creating motion graphic clips. As we saw, the After Effects shape tool, apart from being a very powerful tool, has many capabilities and features that you cannot find in other software, specifically when you want to produce motion graphics that can simplify your job a lot and take way less time from you. So if you want to learn the shapes and their modifiers in detail, as well as how to use them in motion graphic scenes, I recommend you to enroll in my course right now because by the link in the description, you can get it for half price.